coming sir class. In previous class we learned congruency and similarity. We discussed some examples also we discussed. Today we are going to learn congruency of line segments, congruency of angles and congruency of triangles.
Corresponding parts of other triangle,
then the triangles are congruent. So here, if all the parts, nothing but the six elements of triangle, nothing but three sides and three angles of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and angles of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. We will write as a triangle ABC by using symbol congruent to triangle XYZ. When the two triangles have corresponding sides and corresponding angles are equal in the two triangles, then the two triangles are congruent to each other. So look at the corresponding parts, sides and angles in the two triangles ABC and XYZ. So corresponding sides AB and XY both are same, BC and YZ both are same, AC and XZ both are same. Now angles, corresponding angles, angle A and angle X both are same, angle B and angle Y both are same, angle C and angle Z also same. So if corresponding parts of two triangles, nothing but six elements, three sides and three angles are equal to each other, then the two triangles are congruent. Criterion for congruency of triangles. So we have a different criterion of congruency about triangles. So there are five ways to find if two triangles are congruent. So there are how many ways? Five ways to find the two congruent triangles. They are side congruency rule, side angle side congruency rule, angle side angle congruency rule, angle angle side congruency rule, right angle hypotenuse side RHS congruency rule. So here look at the two triangles. Are they superimposed to each other? These two triangles have corresponding sides and angles are same? No. Then these two triangles are congruent? No. Let us take one more triangle. Look at these two triangles. These two triangles are superimposed to each other? Yes, they are superimposed to each other. When they are superimposed to each other, if the two triangles have corresponding sides and angles are same, then the two triangles are congruent. They are superimposed to each other. See, look at here. Corresponding sides and angles are same, then they are superimposed to each other, then these two triangles are congruent. Like this, to show the congruency of triangles, we have five types, five ways are there. They are side congruency rule, side-angle side congruency rule, angle side-angle congruency rule, angle-angle side congruency rule, right-angle hypotenuse side RHS congruency rule. Now let us discuss about briefly about each congruency rule. Let us discuss about the criteria of two congruent triangles. First one, side criterion for congruency. So here, if three sides of a triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent according to side criterion for congruency. So here, two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. So in a triangle, if three sides AB and BC and AC are equal to the corresponding AB is equal to the XY, BC is equal to the YZ, and AC is equal to the XZ, then these two triangles are congruent according to side criterion of congruency rule. So here, in these two triangles, in a triangle, three sides are equal to the corresponding sides, three sides of another triangle, corresponding sides of three sides of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent according to side criterion for congruency. Here, corresponding sides are AB and XY. The corresponding sides are AB and XY, and BC and YZ, and AC and XZ. So these are the corresponding sides. Next, second rule, side angle, SAS criterion for congruence. So here, if two sides and the angle included between the two sides of a triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles, sides and the same included angle between them of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. So here, two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. So here, in triangle ABC, two sides and the included angle between them, between the two sides, the angle included. So same two sides and the included angle to the corresponding two sides and the included angle of another triangle are equal, then the two triangles are congruent according to side angle side. So here, corresponding parts are AB, this AB and XY, AB and XY, and angle B and angle Y, and B and angle Y, and BC and YZ, side BC and YZ. So this is a side criterion of congruence and side angle criterion for congruence. Angle ASA criterion for congruence. Here, if two angles and the included side, two angles and the included side of a triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and included side of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent to each other according to ASA criterion for congruency. So here, two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. Here, two angles and the included side of a triangle. So two angles, angle A and angle B, and the included side is AB, is equal to the corresponding two angles. side of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent according to angle side angle criteria. So here corresponding parts are angle A, angle X, and AB and XY, and angle B and angle Y, angle side angle. So corresponding angles and corresponding side, the two angles and the included side of a triangle are equal to the two angles and included side of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent according to angle side angle criterions for congruence. Next, angle angle side criteria for congruence. So here two angles and the side which is not included side, so two angles and side of triangle are equal to the corresponding two angles and side of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. So look at here, triangle ABC and triangle XYZ. So what they are saying? Two angles and side of a triangle. So this triangle, two angles and one side are equal to the same corresponding two angles and side of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent according to AAS, angle side criteria for congruence. Here corresponding parts are angle A and angle X, corresponding angles A and X, and angle B and angle Y, and side BC and YZ. So in this triangle ABC, two angles and the side are equal to the corresponding two angles and the side of another triangle, then these two triangles are congruent according to angle angle side criterion. So here corresponding parts are the two angles and one side. The two angles are, pair of two angles are angle A and angle X. These two corresponding angles are equal, and angle B and angle Y, these two corresponding angles are equal, and BC and YZ, these two corresponding angles are equal. Fifth one, right angle hypotenuse side, RHS, criterion for congruence. The congruency of triangles, criterion of triangles, this is the last one, right angle hypotenuse side, RHS, criteria of congruence. So here, if the hypotenuse and one side of right angle triangle are equal, which are equal, hypotenuse and one side of right angle triangle, these two are equal to the corresponding hypotenuse and side of another right angle triangle, then the triangles are congruent according to right angle hypotenuse side. So here corresponding parts are angle B and angle Y, both are 90 degrees, and AC and XZ, both are hypotenuse, and BC and YZ, it is an other side. Here right angle hypotenuse side, RHS, congruency. Then we should compare the two right angle triangles. So in a right angle triangle, hypotenuse and the other side are equal to the corresponding hypotenuse and other side of another right angle triangle, then the triangles are congruent to each other according to RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. So this is right angle, angle B and angle Y, corresponding right angles, corresponding hypotenuse AC and XZ, and corresponding sides BC and YZ. Not only base, we can take these two sides also, we can take. So these two corresponding sides should be equal, or these two corresponding sides should be equal. So this is about the congruency of triangles of different ways. Worksheet on congruency of triangles. Define SSS criterion of congruence. Second one, define AAS criterion of congruence. Third one, define RHS criterion of congruence. Again, you should write the definitions of side, angle side, and right angle hypotenuse side criterion of congruence. Keep watching. Thank you.